Assalamualaikum and a very good day to everyone. Hi, 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 with you here today, Nur Balkis binti Khairul Alfian, and I'm from MC2424B. So, today's podcast session is brought to you by IPRMSA UiTM Melaka Chapter, and this topic is actually for subject PRO549 Corporate Creative and Production. Anyway, before we begin, what is zero hunger? Zero hunger is actually one of the key sustainable development goals for 2030. More complex factors than just empty stomachs contribute to hunger, including interconnected problems with poverty, inequality, conflict, climate change, gender discrimination, and also inadequate governmental and health systems. The second Sustainable Development Goals SDG with full description is to end hunger, achieve food security and improve nutrition, and promote sustainable agriculture. At the end of 2021, approximately 193 million people experienced acute hunger. That 828 million isn't the largest figure for world hunger. The FAO estimates that there are 2.3 billion people facing less extreme but still dangerous level of food insecurity. So back to the topic, was Thanos right? I think we can agree that Thanos was right. He did the right thing by sacrificing half of the population in order to make sure the other half will survive in the future. It may seem ruthless, but look at the data. People are happier, the children don't have to worry about food and they don't go to bed hungry. The genocide process was also fair and equitable. There's no background check. It's fair because it could be anybody, no matter how rich or poor you are, it could be anyone.
I was a child when you took me.
I saved you.
No. We were happy on my home planet.
Going to bed hungry, scrounging for scraps. Your planet was on the brink of collapse. I'm the one who stopped that.
If you are a comic head or a Marvel fan, you can see from the first appearance of Thanos in Marvel movie, which is in Avengers' very first movie, which he sent down his soldiers to Earth with Loki's help. We may not see it clearly why he did that, but when Guardians of the Galaxy happen, we can see clearly his mission, which is to find the stones to help him wipe out half of the population. He began to find the stones when he knew about it, and he was restless because it is his one true mission, to save the universe from shrink into its last atom. We can see that his mission is the only solution that will help any civilization to survive by his method? It might not.
Let me guess. Your home?
It was. And it was beautiful. Titan was like most planets. Too many mouths, not enough to go around. And when we faced extinction, I offered a solution.
Genocide.
But random, dispassionate, fair to rich and poor alike. They called me a madman. And what I predicted came to pass.
Congratulations, you're a prophet.
Here is the main problem, the food hunger. Food hunger is a true problem to our existence. The more the people on this planet, the less food left for all of us to share. I'm not talking about being selfish or what, but if one day when we all need to survive for our livelihood, we will be ruthless and selfish when it comes to food. Hence, I think we must discuss the solution to the problem that might happen sooner or later. There is no confirmation about our food stock on this earth about how long they will last, but trust me, sooner or later, we will be out of food. Here is a little bit of data of zero hunger. Okay, World hunger, which affects around 10% of people worldwide, is increasingly after dropping gradually for a decade. As many as 150 million more people become undernourished between 2019 and 2022, a problem mostly fueled by war, climate change, and the COVID-19 pandemic. That is why we need to educate people on zero food hunger. So, who does hunger affect? Here's who is most affected. The first one is people living in poverty. In addition to living in dangerous conditions with dirty water, submerged sanitation, and insufficient access to health services and education, people in underprivileged communities frequently lack access to nutrient-rich food, which contributes to hunger and also malnutrition. And due to their high rates of extreme poverty and climatic shocks, South Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa bear the bulk of the world's burden of severe malnutrition. Malnutrition, however, can affect people anywhere if they are impoverished, homeless, or have other risk factors. The second one is young children. While many people who live in poverty struggle with hunger, children under the age of 5 are particularly vulnerable to it and its potentially fatal effects. Children struggle with study, develop, and even maintain their health when they are hungry. Malnutrition is more likely to affect children who have illnesses like pneumonia, cholera, and also malaria. Malnutrition and illness both impair the immune system. Children who are severely undernourished have a 9 times higher risk of dying from common diseases than their peers who are well-fed. Next is women. Hunger affects women disproportionately in nearly 2/3 of the world's nations. Women are more likely than males to experience hunger and food insecurity. Despite the fact that they prepare and buy food for their families, 90% of the time, women often eat the least and the last in many cultures. According to recent statistics, in 2021, there will be 150 million more hungry women than males. Next one is the most marginalized. The elderly, women, displaced, and refugee population, individuals with disability, and other marginalized members of society are more likely to experience hurdles to accessing basic services, employment opportunities, income, and resources. They are also more susceptible to illnesses such as malnutrition and food insecurity. Next is people in conflict settings. Around 60% of the world's hungry people reside in nations with ongoing hostilities. Harvests are hampered by conflict and families are compelled to evacuate their homes as a result. Lastly is refugees and displaced people. A record number of individuals have been driven from their homes as a result of conflict, famine, persecutors, and breaches of their human rights. Hunger is a significant concern for those who are displaced, including refugees, asylum seekers, and internally displaced individuals, those who leave their homes but remain in their nation of origin.
Yes.
Therefore, as we all can see, Thanos did the right thing. The one and only solution to prevent from our planet Earth to becoming like his planet, Titan. You can say that he is bad, that he is ruthless, but we all know deep down that he is right. That is all from me. Thank you so much for leaning your ears to listen to my podcast session. And as Thanos said, dread it, run from it. Destiny arrives all the same, and now it's here. Or should I say, I am? That is all from me. See you guys next time. Bye!